Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video 20. If you're having a BMW 5 Series guys, generation F10 or F11, the wagon guys, that's from year 2010 to year 2017, any BMW 5 Series. If you need to remove or replace passenger side window switch on the front door guys, stay with us, we'll explain how to do that step by step. There is a few tricks. If you don't do it right, you can actually damage quite a few things on the door panel and it will be expensive guys. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need guys in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these free videos for you. Now, if you need to buy any parts to use for a good price and quick shipping, you want to save quite a bit of money, check out the link in the description of the video below. You can actually get really good parts guys at a really affordable price. So let's go ahead and explain. Okay, how to remove and replace front passenger side window switch now. So first we need to remove, okay, that trim piece right here. So with a plastic panel removal too, if you need to buy some, we'll put the link in the description of the video below. We're going to come underneath, okay, and okay, let's see to find the place, okay, where we can start prying. Okay, you have a two tricky clips, so make sure you stand till the end. We'll explain what we're talking about. Okay, here we have the light tube inside guys, so we have to be extremely careful. Right here there is a light tube, so you have to be extremely careful for that. Right here now there is, okay, one metal clip that you can actually see from top if you're guys looking at it. So gently what you can do, press that one. I'll show you what I'm talking about in a second. Start pulling towards the back. Now you need to grab the whole thing and it needs to slide to the front when it comes out of all the clips, and you slide it to the front. Okay, like that. This clip right here is the one that you need to slide. This is the metal one that you need to reach and release guys. This is the plastic lightning tube, and when you pry on this side and pry on top, not on the bottom, because this one is actually fragile and you can easily damage that one guys. Now what do we have right here? Okay, we have one bolt with Torx 30 that we'll remove in a second. Right here now with the same plastic too, okay, we need to go ahead, okay, and pry the door handle cap. So let me see. How this one will come off. It's a little bit stuck. Okay, this one has a lightning tube too, so you have to be extremely careful guys. So let me just see, okay, where else we have some clips. It's a little bit of a complicated design. You can see my hand right here. Okay, this is guys, okay, from the door handles falling apart that we'll be fixing today. So let me go ahead, okay, figure it out and we'll continue. So we started from the back, that's how it should be. Now there is one more clip kind of like right here. So what I'm going to do, I'll just grab it. Okay, and try to pry too. These are only plastic tools guys here, because if you use other tools, you can damage things quite a bit. Okay, I think it came loose. It looks like there is one clip right here. I can kind of see it. Okay, right there. Okay, this one does not have lightning element. It looks like it is, it's not. Okay, so don't freak out. Perfect. The clips, guys, okay, one clip right here that goes in that hole, one here, and one on the bottom. Three clips. Now we need to get the torque sturdy, start looking big. We need to remove two screws now. And it looks like that door handle, either I peeled it or I wasn't careful, it was peeling on the bottom. So take your time, do not rush things, because you can actually damage quite a few things on that BMW. Okay, one screw is out, second one on top. So you can see we have two of them so far. Perfect. Both of them are identical screws. Now, I don't think we have anything else holding, so I'll go ahead, start with the prying tool, okay, and see if we can get that panel loose. And it could be really, really tight. I might need to get the bigger tools, guys, in action. Let me see, because there is quite a few clips, and those clips will be super tight. So let's go ahead, get the bigger tool. And still having a hard time. It looks like it's holding pretty good, by the way. I can feel one of the clips right here. Okay, one came loose. That's a plus. Once they start going, they go, guys. The first one is the hardest to get. Then you can just do it by hand. Okay, let's check here, because it looks like what could happen here. Okay, that mirror cover might need to come out first. Let me see. Because we need to slide this panel up to come out of the lock, and we cannot slide it up without removing the mirror cover. Okay, let's see. Perfect, we'll leave it here. Now we should be able to come up and come out. And right here, we're going to explain where all the clips are. But let's go ahead now, okay, and explain, guys. Okay, there is a lightening element here. That's the light. It just reflects, okay, through the glass there. Now, that handle, guys, on the bottom, there is one tool that we need to disconnect. Gently, not to break it. And then you pull up. Here we have all the wires that we need to disconnect, including, okay, lightning wires and all other wires as well. But now let me show you where all the clips are located. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. If you have some of the rubber things stuck to the door, remove them and install them on the clip so you will not have vibrations later, because, okay, it will be vibrating and it will be noisy. That's why older cars that have been worked on usually have more vibrations. You can see that's how we remove the door panel. So now right here we have actually two screws, it looks like, guys. Okay, two of them, one little one. This is a Torx 20. Let me go ahead. Okay, remove that one now. And then we have one that's pretty big. I think it's still for the door handle. Let's just verify that. right here. Now let me get the other, okay, the other two that I used earlier. I think it's the same one, Torx 30. So we're going to go ahead, okay, and remove the big one too. Okay, let's make sure we keep the camera in focus. All right, this one's out too. Now let's check what we have here specifically, if we have anything else anywhere. Okay, we have more right here on the bottom, that big one, Torx 30, guys, again right here. Okay, let me see if there is anything else here holding, guys. Okay, let's analyze now. Nope, this one came out of here on the bottom. We might have more, so towards the back right here, one little one that we have. That's always a good thing to watch until the end, so you know, guys, and you don't damage, okay, your car, because sometimes there is hidden clips, bolts, screws and tricks that you may not know, and everything's expensive nowadays, you know, like so easy to break as well, everything's gently made. Perfect. Working on this one now. And if I come on this side now. Okay, looks like the window switch will come with the handle. So what we'll need to do, we're going to replace it anyways. Let me grab one small screwdriver, guys. Okay, because right here there is one clip for the wire. There's one too that I need to kind of like pry a little bit so I can get it out. And there is one, okay, right here. Okay, let's pull. Okay, now right here there is one clip that you're going to press. Okay, one on the back side, and that switch will come out with the door handle. I'll show you where the clips are located. Let me show you. Now looking at it, this is the switch right here. Those are the two clips that you need to press out. Check out how nasty that thing is. Just hate it. So let's go ahead, continue with the next thing. We're going to replace the window switch trim piece as well that it came with the kit. So for the window switch, guys, now if you just need to replace the window switch, okay, you need to remove the door handle because right here there is one tooth, okay, and that tooth, guys, you need to, okay, let's just try to focus, you need to pry to the outside, okay, like that, and then it comes out, and that's your window switch out of here, guys. You can see it just like that. So that's how you guys remove passenger, front passenger window switch on a BMW F10 or F11 generation. If you guys need to buy any parts too, we'll share the link in the description of the video below where you can get them from. Hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you needing help with that. If you have any questions, let us know. We'll be more than glad to make a video if we have a little bit of free time and chance to do that. Hopefully the video was helpful. Thank you for watching and see you next time.